Thank you, Mr. Rajesh and Shekhar, for that generous introduction. Ellarigu namaskara. Today's chief guest, Honorable Minister, Mr. Suresh, other dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I must say that it's a great honor to be here, and I want to thank you all for having given me this opportunity to address this great gathering. I also want to congratulate you all for the wonderful work you all have been doing in the field of, especially in the field of ophthalmology. Our regional chairman has given all the details of exactly what are the service activities they've been doing, especially in ophthalmology. I feel that you all are true warriors of service, crusaders against blindness. Well, I'm sorry, I may deviate a little. You all wanted me to talk on the eye as such, but I thought general health, that includes eye. So I thought I'll share with you some of the health secrets that I really feel is extremely important for each one of us. I truly believe that our health is in our hands. We are what we eat. I'm sure you'll all agree with me that this body of ours is the greatest possession that we have. And our health is the greatest wealth we possess. They say only the value of water is known only when the well dries up. So also, unfortunately, the value of our health we know only when we get sick. If you really want to know the value of health before we get sick, you should visit a cancer hospital, a mental hospital, or a cardiac hospital. Well, every tradition considers this body as a temple. And I don't see why we should put so much of junk into our mouth and convert this temple into a garbage and a graveyard. That's very unfortunate. Well, what I'm trying to tell you is about what's called so-called lifestyle diseases. Almost all the leading causes of death all over the world today is because of these lifestyle diseases. What do I mean by lifestyle? Bad diet options plays a major role in our lifestyle. Others, like a lack of adequate exercise, stress, smoking, alcohol, etc. And what are the diseases they cause? This is the Indian figures. You all know that cardiovascular diseases, heart attacks, 72 million people from our country, I'm sure it's more than that, suffer from this disease. And diabetes, I feel it is actually more than cardiovascular diseases. Almost 63 million diabetics are there. But unfortunately, half of the people who are suffering don't know that they have diabetes. Then you have strokes, 1.5 million, and almost 1 million cancer patients. These diseases are called so-called lifestyle diseases. And the unfortunate thing, why I am stressing this today, is that it was not really so rampant maybe 40 or 50 years back. Why are the numbers shooting through the roof? We need to analyze that. Maybe 5 decades ago, we heard of cancer here or there, some person having heart attack, or a few people having diabetes. But today, I'm sure every single person sitting here has been touched by one of these diseases in the family or friends circle. And the main cause why it has shot like a rocket in the last 4 to 5 decades is just our eating habits. Our eating habits have dramatically changed in the last 5 decades. And look at the statistics. The per capita intake of meat has almost gone up by about 100%. The per capita intake of chicken has gone up by 500% in the last 40 years. And the per capita consumption of cheese has gone up 1,000% in the last 50 years. Yes, I'm giving the statistics from America. That's because we unfortunately try to ape the West. If we live like the West, we eat like the West, we die like the West. That's very unfortunate. Friends, to tell you the truth, I had my first KFC chicken, which is so very popular now. 25 years ago, I had to go to Singapore to eat that because there were no outlets in Bangalore. And today, you know, there must be more than 100 outlets here. It is said that for every KFC outlet that closes down in the US, because they have become aware now, they are suffering more than us, one pops up in India. And we are welcoming them with open arms and also welcoming their diseases with open arms. Whenever we feel sick, we always blame our parents. How come you got diabetes? Well, sir, my father had diabetes. My mother had diabetes. It's not true. Of course, I'm not trying to say genes do not play a role. Genes do have a role. But genes are like seeds. Provided they are given the right environment, they will sprout. This experiment has been done on what's called identical twins. They have exactly the same genes. And these identical twins, when they have different lifestyles, as I've seen here, one, a healthy lifestyle on your left side and the other, an unhealthy lifestyle, they will have totally different kind of diseases. That means the environment must be right for the gene to express itself. Well, maybe around 4 to 5 decades ago, it was the 30-year-old son bringing the 60-year-old father for a heart treatment. Unfortunately, today, it has reversed. It is a 60-year-old father bringing the 30-year-old son for heart treatment. That is the situation today. I must tell you, friends, that for the first time ever in history, the younger generation of today will have a shorter lifespan than the current generation. This is because of their eating habits, which can easily be changed. And here we have, way back in the 90s, it has been proved. This is what is called a cardiac angiogram. You know, the one on your left, wherein there is a blocked or narrowing of the cardiac artery, and that could lead to what's called heart attacks. And just by changing the diet, it has been clinically proven that only changing the diet to a plant-based diet, that the same vessels, when imaged 2 years later, have completely opened up. That is the power of diet. You change your diet, that could save your life. They say that the true age of a person is directly proportional to the health of his arteries. What happens in all these diseases? We say so many diseases, and I say the problem is because of the diet, and the cure is because of from the diet. That's because of our bad diet, our arteries get narrowed, they get clogged, they get crippled, they become stiff. And this, since the arteries are the source of oxygen and nutrition to every cell, every organ of this body, when it is, you know, deprived of this, they become sick and you get heart attacks, you get strokes, you get kidney problems, you get, you know, you lose sight. So diet is the culprit, and that's what I want to tell you today. One other disease that's there everywhere. Adike helta idru Buddha avaru helidrante, you know, saavilidid mane saasveta anta ivag naavu helbodu sakre kayile illidid mane saasveta anta heli sakre kayile illidid manene illa hagaagibittide. Nan medical college ottaa irbekidre, that was in the early 80s, only 5% of the adult population of our country suffered from diabetes. And today, that rate is 30%. And we will soon be declared as the diabetic capital of the world. That is the, you know, the problem that is facing us. This can easily be, you know, prevented, treated, and reversed by simply changing what we eat. Well, now I've told you the problem. Now, what is the problem? What is the actual problem? This came as a shock to me, that milk is culprit number one. I'm sure most of you would be surprised. What is this? Our fathers, grandfathers, and we've been having milk for generations together, and nothing happened. Now, why now? There's a lot, big difference between what the milk they drank and the milk we drink. And moreover, even the milk they drank, because they didn't have enough science to tell them that it was not right. Today, we are drinking adulterated milk with all the bad fats and with all the bad proteins in them. This is the problem. Why milk I take is that, you know that, you know, we have in India itself, you know, almost half the population is vegetarian, another half is non-vegetarian. But all of us suffer from the same diseases, don't we? So where is the problem then? Problem is the vegetarians make up for not eating meat by having extra amount of milk and the concentrated version of it, that is butter, ghee, oils and the rest, which compensate for the meat and causes the same diseases in both vegetarians and non-vegetarians. Well, here you have one of the, you know, leading doctors saying that the casein, that's the protein in milk, is a significant carcinogen, which has been scientifically proven. Why would anyone knowingly, you know, drink a thing that causes cancer and give it to our loved ones? Children actually don't really love milk. Initially, they are forced to drink milk. The mothers chase them with milk because we have been brainwashed to think that milk is good for health, milk is good for bones, milk has calcium, and it is necessary, absolutely necessary. That's very unfortunate, because that has happened because of the very strong lobby and industry, and that's why we have been all brainwashed. Here I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, see, we are about the only species in the world that drink milk after we are weaned, and that also not our own but of another species. See, Mother Nature makes milk for different species, and the constituent, how the composition of that milk is totally different. A cow when is born is around, a calf is around 60 pounds, and maybe within about 90 to 100 days that calf has got to reach a weight of around 350 pounds. So Mother Nature has made it such that the constitution of that milk, that is the kind of growth that the calf requires. When we drink that milk, you know, it is definitely going to be damage our health. That is the problem here. So we are, as I told you, the only species that do this, and that's why we are suffering. Moreover, in the present day, the milk that we get is totally adulterated with hormones, pesticides, chemicals, antibiotics. We are consuming all this, and that's causing havoc. And just see the benefits that you are getting. These are all scientifically proven benefits by completely giving up dairy. I couldn't fit it into one slide, so I had to even carry it to the other slide. Almost all the common problems that we suffer from, all the allergies, all the skin problems, all the actually the what's called hormonal dependent cancers, like the most common cancer in ladies, the breast cancer, the most common cancer in men called prostate cancer, all directly related to consumption of milk. So, ladies and gentlemen, think very seriously about this. And of course, the second culprit here is meat. I want to tell you that we are structurally, anatomically, and physiologically built to eat vegetarian food, plant-based food. Look at, starting from our anatomy, our teeth. Look at the teeth of carnivores. Look at the teeth of omnivores. And look at the teeth of herbivores. Don't our teeth resemble that of the horse or the cow? So we are built, not just teeth, let's go a little deeper. Our intestines, Our intestines are almost 10 to 12 times the small intestine, the length of a vertebral column. And the intestines of all carnivores are very, very short, about 3 times the length of their vertebral column. So that when they eat meat, it is thrown out immediately so that it doesn't putrefy in the body. And in case you have a longer intestine, it is going to cause a mess there. So we are, as I told you, anatomically and physiologically not built to eat meat. We are consuming the wrong food. And so that we do not have that physiologically built to eat meat, the cholesterol that is in the meat, that's clogging our arteries. The bad proteins, that's causing problems. And look here, none other than the WHO itself has classified processed meat as a group 1 carcinogen. That means processed meat causes cancer. How can we eat this morning and evening and remain healthy? It's just not possible. And the most important part is that what our body requires is fibers. And meat and milk have absolutely no fibers. Fibers are found only in plants. Well, that's the reason why I say meat and milk are similar. Milk is nothing but liquid meat. That's why both vegetarians and non-vegetarians suffer from the same disease. Well, another thing you may say, can I have an egg? The price that you may have to pay for an egg is with your life. It has been estimated that an egg is equal to almost 5 cigarettes. The bad cholesterol in there is again going to block your arteries. Well, let me give you one statistic, just one. This is the death from heart problems in Norway. Well, see how it start increasing. And in the year 1939, during the First World War, the Germans, they took over Norway. Not only did they take over Norway, they also took away all their animal farms, livestock. That they wanted them to feed their soldiers so that Norwegians were forced to eat vegetables, a plant-based diet. And just look at what happened to the heart death due to heart problems from the year 1939 to around till 1945. It systematically dropped. And then in 1945, after the war, when the Germans left, the Norwegians got back the livestock, and then again you see the death due to heart problems rose very sharply. This proves beyond the shadow of doubt that meat is a killer. Well, what I am trying to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, here is that you may own the most powerful car in the world, the most expensive car in the world. If you are going to fill it with the wrong fuel, it's not going to take you far. Not just wrong fuel, the wrong adulterated fuel. It will definitely not move. That's exactly what we are doing to our body, and that's exactly why we are all suffering. Well, what is the alternative? As I've been mentioning, the alternative is we are built to eat plants, and we must eat plants. Why? Plants are highly nutritious, they are loaded with micronutrients, and of course, they have what's called good proteins and good fats that suit our physiology. But most important, as I told you, mentioned before, what meat and milk do not have, that is the fibers. You may think, after all, what is this fiber? It's plant roughage. But it plays a vital role in our health. There you are. It helps to maintain the good bacteria in our gut. It's absolutely important for our health. It prevents sugars from getting into our bloodstream and slows down the absorption. And most important is, it doesn't allow you to overeat. And this is how it acts. If you are to eat 400 calories of oil, your stomach will be filled to less than 1/4. And if you eat 400 calories of chicken, maybe about 1/4, and 400 calories of vegetable will fill your stomach and you'll feel full, and there is no chance of you overeating, because all the so-called lifestyle diseases are because we take excess calories, wrong calories. Well, these are the harmful foods which I've already mentioned. And then you may say, what are the things I can eat? here you are. All the things that we enjoy. You can eat, you can have your idlis, you can have your dosa. Only thing, it should not be polished. When they polish, they take away the good and add the bad. So it must be whole food. You can have fruits, you can have nuts, you can have your chutney, you can have your sambar. Just reduce the amount of oil in all of these. Well, the guidelines to have a healthy food, it must be plant-based, it must be whole, it must be organic as far as possible to reduce the pesticides. And two things we need to monitor when we change over is to, you know, check our vitamin B12 and vitamin D. And the results are simply remarkable. Of course, our main aim is not to lose weight, but your weight comes down, your blood pressure comes down, your sugar comes down, your blood cholesterol comes down, and all the deadly diseases like heart attacks, cancers can all be prevented just by changing your diet. Well, how to get back on track? And the whole problem to break any habit, three most important things to break any behavior is, first is your mind. Second is the mind, and third is your mind. It is just a mental block and a mental makeup. If you decide, you can do it. You might have done it for years together, but you know that it is not good for you, you convince your mind, then it's not difficult. Well, you need to get back on track. You need to reverse the deep conditioning that's been there for years together. Motivate yourself, eat mindfully, and once you start it, you will see the results. You don't have to wait for months and years. You will see the results, ladies and gentlemen, within weeks. And have a higher purpose in life. As you all have higher purposes, service above self, that's one higher purpose. Another higher purpose is in life. You want to see your grandchildren grow. You want to see them graduate. You even want to dance at their wedding. You can't do that if you're in a wheelchair. So if you have such higher purpose, then definitely you can change. And also I insist that it's just not the food, although food plays 80% role in your health, but exercise and reducing stress are also very important. When to get back on track? It is never too early, it is never too late. If anybody in this hall is above the age of 10, with the current type of diet that we eat, that is the time arteries have already started narrowing. Atherosclerosis. That means if you are above the age of 10, you are not trying to prevent diseases, you are trying to reverse diseases because the narrowing of arteries have already begun. So it's never too late, it's never too early. But the sad point is that nobody wants to, you know, take a changed lifestyle, and that's why hospitals are overloaded and crowded. I was just talking to our minister, even if you double the number of doctors, double the number of hospitals, it is just not sufficient to handle the load. So the best way is prevention. So what I request you, friends, is that, you know, convince yourself, don't be afraid to go alone, to travel the road less traveled, and the path that is the truth. Well, I just want to tell you, the oldest, the strongest, and the largest, all of these plants. The first time when you say, I'm changing my diet, oh God, where will you get your calcium from? Ask these people where they get their calcium from. They don't drink milk. They will say, where will you get your, stopping meat, where will you get your protein from? Ask these animals where they get their proteins from. They don't eat meat. So all of them can live because they are living and eating according to their physiology, according to how nature has made them. Here you have some very, very huge number of people who are in the so-called developed countries. It is catching up like fire. So much so that the two of the leading dairies in the United States have announced their bankruptcy. That's the current stage in the developed countries. Menaka Gandhi has very rightly said that first you eat meat, and then the meat eats you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll just take two more minutes. I have given you the facts and figures, but facts and figures don't change behavior, but sometimes stories do. I just want to tell you what happened to me. I am 66 years old, and I've been a diabetic for over 25 years. That means in my early 40s, I got diabetes, and like everybody else, I blame my genes and my parents for that. And as usual, went to the doctor, started on tablets, and along this 25 years, the tablets kept on increasing, the sugars kept on increasing. And you know, diabetes is a disease with bad friends. All along with came, you know, high cholesterol, kidney problems, bladder problems, prostate problems. So much so that till June last year, I was taking a dozen drugs every day. And in June last year, I, thank God, came across this truth and I changed once and for all. In the last 8 months, I must tell you, all these have been reduced. I have been abusing this body for almost 65 years. And I must tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that in 65 days, things started reversing. So much so that today, my diabetes is under control with 1/4 of the tablets. My cholesterol is totally gone with no tablets. My kidney numbers are extremely good. My cholesterol numbers are much better. My prostate problem is gone. My bladder is fine. This is the current state. It is so simple. It is so safe. It is so easy. I feel like a superhuman being. Actually, I've been a doctor, you know, treating eyes all these days, but I feel, you know, these are much bigger than that. It can be followed by any simple person. You don't need a doctor to do this. And then you will see this magic happening. It's nothing short of a miracle, ladies and gentlemen. So please give this a serious thought. If you are killing yourself with every morsel that you put into your mouth, with every meal that you have, you are shooting yourself in the foot. You need not believe anything that I have said, but you have to convince yourself about the truth, because there is so much science behind this. Here, I have given you some references. Amir Khan, for that matter, tell you, he just saw a video titled Uprooting the Leading Causes of Death, and on that very same day, he changed. I saw the video, What the Health? It's a 1 hour documentary, and I instantly changed, because I know that is the truth and there is science behind it. It is evidence-based diet. And recently there is a movie on Netflix that came, The Game Changers. I would urge each one of you to see this movie. It's on Netflix. Fantastic movie. All Olympians who have changed and who have faring so well during their career. Ladies and gentlemen, last generation we fought a battle against tobacco. Today we need to fight a battle for our health. If you want to say goodbye to diabetes, if you want to say goodbye to heart attacks, if you want to say goodbye to strokes, if you want to say goodbye to most of the cancers, if you want to say goodbye to your doctor, kindly take my words seriously and follow it. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಮಾತು ಬಲ್ಲವನಿಗೆ ಜಗಳವಿಲ್ಲ, ಊಟ ಬಲ್ಲವನಿಗೆ ರೋಗವಿಲ್ಲ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಲೇಡೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜೆಂಟ್.